important point is at the critical angle, this is your incident direction and this is your final direction. This is theta c, so naturally angle of deviation becomes 90 degree minus theta c. So that's one important point in the graph. The shape of the graph before that is complex. Just remember that it's a curved graph, it's not a straight line. You know, because of Snell's law, it's a complex relation between I and R, it's not a straight line. Then uske aage kya ho jayega? Just after critical angle, let's say your angle of incidence is still approximately your critical angle, but now this direction is for your incident ray and this direction is for your final ray. So the angle between your incident ray and your final ray is this. So this big angle becomes your angle of deviation. And you can calculate it carefully. You can see that this entire angle was 180 degrees. Just may say this angle is 2 theta c. Therefore, the yellow angle obviously has to be 180 minus 2 theta c. So just after critical angle, there's a sudden jump in the graph. And the angle becomes 180 degrees minus 2 theta c. And finally, that point forward, we know it's going to be a straight line. How? So that point forward, reflection takes place. So if this is your angle of incidence and that's your angle of reflection, obviously reflection ke baad our angle of deviation can be found in terms of angle of incidence. It's always going to be quite clear from the diagram. Angle of deviation will always be the 180 degrees minus twice of angle of incidence. Ye hai twice of angle of incidence. So that angle will always be 180 degrees minus twice of angle of incidence. 180 degrees minus twice of angle of incidence, that's a straight line graph. And when your angle of incidence is 90 degrees, according to that formula, delta becomes zero again. And as expected, if your angle of incidence was really 90, then your final reflected ray will also be along the surface. So there'll be no deviation. Okay, so your deviation will again finally become zero. Yeah, that was just a quick recap of this graph. I think this is where we ended the previous class with this question. You know, remember this question? There's a swimming pool and a source of light placed at the bottom. All right. Okay. So one of you is saying they had missed the previous class. That's all right. Watch the recording, because what we're going to do today is something new. All right, so we're going to look at prisms. Very small idea in prisms. It's not a big concept. So let's quickly finish it and then we can move on. Maybe we can start the next idea as well. Ab dekho, prisms mein, first of all, what is a prism? Some people are a little confused as to what the shape really is. Please bear in mind, a prism is not a pyramid. You know, this is how a pyramid looks. Pyramid always has a point top. A prism is not like that. In fact, how does a prism look in reality? It looks like this. So its shape is going to be somewhat like this. This is how a prism looks. I hope that makes sense. Just a Toblerone ka bar hai waisa. So it looks like the roof of a house. Okay? Like the roof of a house. There are two triangles, one triangle over here, yes, and one triangle over there. And the other three sides are rectangles. So two triangles, one at the front, one at the back, and all the other sides are rectangles. And whenever we'll study a prism, for us, our light rays are always... the parallel faces, the triangles are of course parallel and the rectangles are not parallel. Yeah. For a prism, whenever we study it in optics, our light is always going to land on the rectangular faces. See? That's how we'll always study. It will enter the one rectangular face, it will leave another rectangular face. In fact, what we will be doing, drawing in our diagrams, will just be the front view of the prism. So a prism in our diagram will always look like a triangle and light rays are always going to enter through this rectangular face on the side and leave through another rectangular face on the side. That's how our diagrams are going to be. So a prism in reality is like this, but our front view is going to look like a triangle. And you can imagine this triangle to extend into the plane of your screen to get a three-dimensional object. But every cross-section of this is a triangle. All right, hold on. Don't panic. I've not mentioned anything except what a prism is. I'm going to come to the diagram in a bit. Well, that's what a prism is. See, is it just a triangular shape? 3D object jiska har cross section ek triangle hai. Think it's a triangle extending into your screen. Now let me just explain what all I've labeled over here. So I'll just zoom in a bit. First of all, I've labeled the prism with the alphabets L, M, N, N. Think so the prism is triangle L, M, N. The next thing I've labeled in this diagram is the path of your light. So your light first comes along the path PQ, which I've labeled in gray, and PQ is your incident ray. And this angle over here is called your angle of incidence. I is your angle of incidence. Uske aage, this ray undergoes refraction. So this blue dashed line that I've drawn is actually the normal at the point of incidence. So as it undergoes refraction, our ray bends towards the normal. And then it strikes the plane, the second plane at some other point, at point R. So QR becomes my refracted ray. QR is my refracted ray. Ab point of refraction pe bhi ek aur normal maine draw kiya hai. So I've drawn both the normals and I have labeled the point where these two normals meet as T. We will use this point aage thoda derivation ke waqt. So I've labeled the second normal as well. Now, the angles that my refracted ray makes with these normals, ek hoga first surface wale normal ke saath, and dusra nikalte waqt second surface wale normal ke saath, those two angles I'm going to label as R1 and R2. And those two, let's call them, are angles of refraction at the two faces of the prism. R1 will be at the first face and R2 will be at the second face. Okay? What else have I labeled on my diagram? Now, when this ray finally emerges, okay? Finally emerges, it's going to again bend away from the normal this time because it's going from glass to air. So it'll bend away from the normal. And this final ray, let's call that our emergent ray, which is along the line RS. And the angle it makes with the normal will be called angle of emergence. Now, to emerge means to come out. So finally, when it comes out, what is the angle? Angle of emergence. All right. So we're going to represent by that by the symbol E. All right. One of you is asking me, is this going to be parallel to the base? Absolutely not. Okay. Absolutely not. I have deliberately tried to show on the diagram as well that they are not parallel. Aisa zarurat nahi hai ki it will be parallel to the base. Is the light ray splitting up? Absolutely not. Ye light ray is following the path PQRS. It's just bending in places, in two places because of refraction. Split up nahi ho raha hai. We are assuming, I think you mean our prism splits up white light into its different colors. We are not looking at that right now. We're not looking at, that's called dispersion. We're just seeing how light of one color, monochromatic light, would pass through this prism. Monochromatic means light of one frequency. So we're just going to see how that passes through the prism. Color wala aspect baad mein aayega. Now, we may learn dispersion towards the end, or we may learn it in a different chapter. Technically, that is a different chapter. Technically, dispersion is not in your advanced syllabus. So we may learn it in a different chapter or we may learn it towards the end. Don't worry about that now. Acha, now just have a look at this. I'm going to extend my incident ray. That was the direction. And I'm also going to extend my emergent ray. So ye ho gaya uska direction. I've just decided to call their meeting point as O. And if you can look at this closely, the angle between the incident ray and the emergent ray obviously becomes your angle of deviation. All right, so angle of deviation is the angle between the incident ray and the emergent ray. Angle of deviation is typically represented by the symbol delta. It's always represented by the symbol delta. Okay. Cool. That's everything in this diagram. One more important element in this diagram is, if you look closely, this angle at the top is what I've labeled as A, and A is defined as the angle of the prism. So the angle at the top will be the angle of the prism. All right, so that is a significant angle. Somebody is asking me, can I give it a different name? You can give it any different name, but I will call it angle of prism. That's what your textbook will call it as well. Okay, and कोई पूछ रहा है टी का क्या पॉइंट है, टी अब दिखेगा आगे के डेरिवेशन में, हम टी यूज करेंगे. All right, but all clear till here. I hope you understand all the symbols that I've used, and I hope you can now follow through this definition, through this derivation. Is there variation in angle of prism for different prisms? Absolutely. So based on how you take your prism, you'll have a different angle of prism. See, it also depends on how you place your prism. If a prism has different angles, everything depends on how you place the prism. The angle at the top will be the angle of the prism. Yeah, or in other words, if light enters this surface and leaves to that surface, so the angle between the two surfaces, the angle between these two surfaces, that is the angle of the prism for that orientation. So it also depends on how you place the prism. Yeah. So the angle between the two surfaces undergoing refraction can also be considered the angle of the prism. Okay, so whatever is at the top when you're performing the experiment, that becomes the angle of the prism for that experiment, for that orientation. Okay. Okay. Now, ab dekho, quadrilateral LQTR. So consider this quadrilateral LQTR. All right, so you know that all of the internal angles of a quadrilateral must add to 360 degrees. All internal angles add to 360 degrees. But if you notice closely, two of the angles, LQT and LRT, they are already 90 degrees. This angle and this angle, they are already perpendicular. And those two angles are already 90 degrees. So out of four angles, jinka sum 360 hona chahiye, two angle already 90 hai. Matlab wo two angle ka sum, wo two angle ka sum kitna aana chahiye? So 180 aana chahiye. Theek hai? Wo two angle ka sum 180 aana chahiye. And 180 अगर आएगा, कोई बोल रहा है कि I've written this sign twice, okay, fine, thank you. Okay. ठीक, वो दो एंगल का सम 180 आना चाहिए. अगर वो दो एंगल का सम 180 आएगा तो बच्चे दो एंगल का भी सम 180 फिर आना चाहिए. तो ठीक है, it forms a cyclic quadrilateral, that's fine. In saying it forms a cyclic quadrilateral, but now the main point is ki this angle plus this angle add to 180 degrees. See, these two are adding to 180, so the remaining two also have to add to 180 because total milke 360 hona chahiye. So if these two angles add to 180 degrees, that means angle QTR plus the angle of the prism must add to 180 degrees. Angle QTR plus the angle of the prism must add to 180 degrees. Got that? Everyone with me till this point? All angles add to 360, two are 90, unka sum 180 ho raha hai, to bache do ka sum bhi 180 hona chahiye. So angle QTR plus A should add to 180 degrees. All right, the next point I'm going to take is, I'm going to take triangle QTR. So triangle QTR में क्या होएगा, ट्राइंगल क्यू टी आर में वी नो ऑल द एंगल्स ऑफ अ ट्राइंगल शुड ऐड टू 180, मतलब एंगल क्यू टी आर, ये वाला एंगल प्लस आर वन प्लस आर टू शुड ऑल्सो एड टू 180 डिग्रीज, बिकॉज ऑल द एंगल्स ऑफ अ ट्राइंगल शुड ऐड टू 180. तो अब ये दो से तुम्हें क्या मिल रहा है, इफ यू लुक एट दीज टू इक्वेशन साइड बाई साइड, वॉट ऑब्वियस कंक्लूजन इज कमिंग आउट ऑफ दिस, what obvious conclusion is coming out of this? Yes, the conclusion we're getting is r1 plus r2 is equal to a, angle qtr plus a is 180, angle qtr plus r1 plus r2 is 180. So yahan se aa raha hai ki a is equal to r1 plus r2. All right, so that is an important result that you can remember. That is an important result that you have to remember. See, let me just try to get rid of this pink. Ah, perfect. See, that's an important result to remember. A is R1 plus R2. For all prisms, A is R1 plus R2. Cool? Can I proceed? All right, so I've copied the same diagram on the... You didn't get how A is R1 plus R2. ये इक्वेशन समझ में आया, क्वाड्रिलैटरल के हिसाब से क्यू टी आर प्लस ए इज 180, फिर ट्राइंगल का इंटरनल एंगल्स 180 तक ऐड होना चाहिए, तो क्यू टी आर प्लस आर वन प्लस आर टू इज 180. तो लुक एट दैट, नो, जहां पे फर्स्ट इक्वेशन में ए है वहीं पे दूसरे इक्वेशन में आर वन प्लस आर टू है. ऑब्वियस कंक्लूजन क्या है कि ए इज इक्वल टू आर वन प्लस आर टू. गॉट इट? And one of you is asking, does A have to be 60 degrees? Should the prism be equilateral? Absolutely not. A can be anything. It'll always be given in the question. It'll always be given in the question. A can be absolutely anything. See? Now, moving on. Look at triangle OQR. So O kidhar hai? O ye hai. Remember, O is the point where the incident ray and the emergent ray meet when extended. So if you look at triangle OQR, then I hope you remember this property that you may have learnt in school. External angle is sum of the two internal angles. Padha hai na school mein? So delta is equal to angle OQ. In this triangle, delta is equal to angle OQR plus ORQ. Makes sense? Delta is the external angle. The external angle is equal to angle OQR plus ORQ. Everyone got that? Angle OQR plus ORQ. Now, what is angle OQR? Look closely. Yahan pe, if you can see, this is your incident ray. And this is your normal. Angle between them over there is I. Angle between them over here is I. So angle OQR. Nikalne ke liye, clearly this big gray angle is I. This yellow angle is R1. So OQR is obviously I minus R1. OQR is obviously I minus R1. And similarly, ORQ. So again, this... big angle is E, the big red angle is E, the small yellow angle is R2. So ORQ, ye bacha hua angle is obviously E minus R2. All right, so angle OQR is I minus R1 and ORQ is E minus R2. I hope everyone can see that. Angle IQR is I minus R1 and ORQ is E minus R2. Okay, and then you just rearrange things and you get another result to memorize. So delta is I plus E minus R1 plus R2. Delta is I plus E minus R1 plus R2. So delta delta is I plus E minus R1 plus R2. And when I bring R1 plus R2 to the left-hand side, I can say delta plus R1 plus R2 is I plus E. But R1 plus R2 kya tha? R1 plus R2 tumhara angle of prism ke barabar tha. So that's how I get a second formula to memorize. So there are two important formulas to memorize. One is A is equal to R1 plus R2 and the other is this. Delta plus A is I plus E. Simple, delta plus A is I plus E. Any confusion in this? See, in the end, you just memorize these two results. A is R1 plus R2 and the next is delta plus A is I plus E. All right. तो आयुष उससे आएगा कि ए एंड क्यू टी आर का सम 180 है. यू सेइंग दैट इज बिहेविंग लाइक अ साइक्लिक क्वाड्रिलेटरल एंड ए प्लस क्यू टी आर इज 180. ए नीड नॉट बी डबल ऑफ क्यू टी आर, है ना, वो दिख नहीं रहा. एक मिनट, अनम्यूट कराना है क्या?
हेलो सर.
हाँ बोलो
सर. क्योंकि LQTR अगर साइक्लिक क्वाड्रिलेटरल है तो फिर एक टाइप से QR एक क्वाड का काम करेगी. इट एक्ट्स एज अ क्वाड इनसाइड अ सर्कल.
अग्रीड.
एंड द एंगल सबटेंडेड बाय द क्वाड एट द मेजर आर्क इज ट्वाइस ऑफ द एंगल सबटेंडेड एट द माइनर आर्क.
नहीं, एक बड़ी
It was twice or half. I am forgetting something.
That has to do with angle subtended at the center. Angle subtended at the major arc is twice of, is half of the angle subtended at the center.
Yes, sir. Okay.
That doesn't have to do with this angle.
Got it, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. All right. One of you wanted to see this. I hope you're done with this page. Yeah, and to be honest, at the end of the day, when I revise this chapter, I mean, I don't go over the derivation again. In the exam also, I'm not going to go over the derivation. In the exam, I'm just going to use these two results that I remember. So, delta plus A is I plus E, ye yaad karna hai. And yahan pe A is R1 plus R2, wo yaad karna hai. These are two important results. See, ye page mein kya doubt hai? डेल्टा का साइन इज अ ग्रीक अल्फाबेट डेल्टा. यू माइट हैव सीन टू डेल्टास. देयर इज वन डेल्टा लुक्स लाइक अ ट्रायंगल. दिस इज द स्मॉलर डेल्टा एंड दिस इज द बिगर डेल्टा. कैपिटल डेल्टा छोटा डेल्टा. जैसे कैपिटल ए एंड स्मॉल ए लुक डिफरेंट, वैसे कैपिटल डेल्टा एंड स्मॉल डेल्टा लुक. एंड व्हाट डू थीटा एंड डेल्टा सिग्निफाई? थीटा तो इस डायग्राम में है ही नहीं किधर भी. डेल्टा स्टैंड्स फॉर एंगल ऑफ डिविएशन. आई हैव रिटन इट ओवर हियर. इनफैक्ट पहले भी मैंने जो आज जो ग्राफ रिवाइज किया ना, डिविएशन वर्सेस एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस का, उसमें भी आई हैव यूज्ड द सेम सिंबल फॉर डेल्टा. दिस इज द सिंबल नॉर्मली दैट विल बी यूज्ड फॉर एंगल ऑफ डिविएशन. Okay, cool, no problem. Somebody is asking me small and capital omega. Yeah, ek kaam karo, best tum thoda Google kar lo how small omega, capital omega, how different symbols look. Okay. Pooch liya to bata deta hu, ye this is capital omega and that's small omega. Capital omega, small omega. But aisa every alphabet has a capital alphabet symbol and a small alphabet symbol, so you can Google it out and check. Okay. Now, delta versus angle of incidence. All right. So, as we vary the angle of incidence, we find that delta in a prism changes, the angle of deviation changes, and we get a graph which looks like the one I've drawn. Now, you don't have to mathematically ever figure out that graph. That's not within our scope. Okay, it's a slightly more complex graph. There are refractions at two surfaces, sine, sine inverse, a mil-mil ke complex function hai. But the shape of the graph is going to look like this. It is going to look like a U-shaped graph. Ek second, jaldi dekh lo. Okay, so the shape of the delta versus I graph is going to be a U-shaped graph, and this comes experimentally. All right, and now our job is just to remember how the graph looks and understand some important implications from the graph. Done with this page? Okay, so it's not a parabola, as one of you is asking. Please, every single U-shaped curve in this world is not a parabola. It's not a parabola. It's not a quadratic equation. It's a very complex sine of sine inverse, vagera vagera, vaisa type ka equation. Okay, so it's not a parabola, but it's a U-shaped curve which looks like this. Okay, and this graph can be found easily experimentally. What you now need to know in this graph is that somewhere there occurs an angle of incidence, jiske liye there is an angle of minimum deviation. This graph has a minima. There is a minimum angle of deviation. And that angle of minimum deviation occurs at a unique angle of incidence. The angle of minimum deviation occurs at a unique angle of incidence. The word unique means single. ठीक है? ऐसे ही random सा नाम दे दिया, theta m. Theta m क्यों? Theta for minimum. Okay? Okay, let me address your doubts at this stage one by one. Theta c, nahin, nothing to do with critical angle over here. ठीक है? Critical angle is in the past. कहानी खत्म. Nothing to do with critical angle over here. One of you is saying, what makes it different from a parabola? Baba, कोई भी random सा U-shaped curve parabola नहीं होता है. Only a quadratic equation. Y is AX square plus BX plus C. Only a quadratic equation becomes a parabola. Yeah. So, parabola is a very specific type of curve. Any random sa U-shaped curve will not be a parabola. Okay? So all I'm saying is this graph created by performing an experiment. You hold a prism, look at different angles of incidence and measure the angles of deviation, and then that's how such a graph has been created. Our job is to observe a few important things in the graph. So we should know the overall shape of the graph looks like this. One thing we should know is this graph has a minima. So if this graph has a minima, that means there is a minimum angle of deviation. Ek point se kam, isse kam deviation possible nahi hai. There is a minima which occurs at a specific angle of incidence. It occurs at a unique angle of incidence. Unique matlab wo deviation ke liye ek hi angle of incidence exist karta hai, do value exist nahi karta hai. But agar koi aur deviation tumhe chahiye for all other angles of deviation, there exist two angles of incidence. Jaise for example, agar tumhe itna angle of deviation chahiye koi random sa value, you can notice ki that angle of deviation occurs at two different angles of incidence, occurs at theta 1 and theta 2. But minimum deviation will occur at only one angle of incidence. Samajh mein aaya yahan tak? There is a minima of this graph. Kya dikh raha hai graph se? Ek minima hai. Minima ek specific angle pe banta hai. Ek specific angle of incidence pe minimum deviation milta hai. And baki sare angles of deviation, do alag alag angles of incidence pe mil sakta hai. Did you get this? Is it clear from the graph? I and E ka baat thodi der mein karunga. One of you is still asking, how can there be two angles of incidence? So just think about it. Na? firstly, please try to understand how a graph works. So what is this graph? This graph is telling me as I change my angle of incidence, delta kaise change hoga. So delta, you know, it starts from a high value, okay? And then it reaches a minima, and then it again starts to rise. Okay? It starts from a particular value, reaches a minima, and again starts to rise. So as you can see in this graph, as you can see in this graph, delta minimum ka formula aage aayega, but as you can see in this graph, for every angle above delta minimum, there are two angles of incidence. Yahan pe ek theta m se chote value pe bhi wo delta aayega, aur baad mein bhi ek aur angle of incidence pe wo delta aayega. So for every angle of deviation that takes place, you have two angles of incidence, except where, except at the lowest point occurs at a unique input, at a unique angle of incidence. And obviously, usse kam delta ke liye koi bhi angle of incidence hai. Again, yeah, that goes without saying. Clear? Okay till here? Okay till this point? Okay. Now, theta m is just a random symbol. Theta m is the angle of incidence at which there is a minimum angle of deviation. Theta m is the angle of incidence at which there's a minimum angle of deviation. Theta m zyada important nahi hai, delta m important hai. On the other hand, theta m maine bas graph mein representation ke purpose ke liye maine draw kiya hai. Okay, there exists a unique angle for which delta m occurs. All right, ab dekho, ab ek cheez samajh lo. Imagine this is my prism. All right, and let's say my angle of incidence is over here. Let's say my angle of incidence is theta 1. See, let's say my angle of incidence is theta 1, and this time I send my light rays in this direction. Now I don't know what my angle of emergence is. See, I don't know what my angle of emergence is, but maan lo ki is case mein kuch to delta aata hai. Let's say delta aata hai. See, angle of deviation itna aata hai. Imagine if I were to send the same light ray in the opposite direction. Do you agree ki isme bhi same delta aayega? Because lines to wahi hai, bas path, ha, lines utna hi hai, bas path reverse ho gaya hai. Same delta aa raha hai jab main ulta bhej raha hu. Same delta aa raha hai jab ulta bhej raha hu. But this angle is something different. So what can this angle be? What can this other angle of incidence be? As we know ki delta occurs for two angles. Agar left wala angle theta 1 tha, to right wala angle naturally theta 2 hoga. Hai na? Right wala angle naturally theta 2 hoga. Samajh mein aaya what I'm trying to say now. So I assumed ki my angle of incidence is theta 1. Theta 1 pe kuch to delta aaya. लाइट का वैल्यू रे को उल्टा भेजा तो एक नया एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस पे सेम डेल्टा आया. सो द नया एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस शुड देन बी थीटा 2. एंड देन द मिनट आई लेबल दिस डायग्राम यू सडनली रियलाइज कि इफ माय एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस वाज थीटा 1 देन माय एंगल ऑफ इमर्जेंस विल बी थीटा 2. सो दे गो हैंड इन हैंड. When my angle of incidence is theta 1, my angle of emergence is theta 2. And when I send light the opposite way, when my angle of incidence is theta 2, my angle of emergence is theta 1. Got it? So when I say ki delta itna hai, and delta occurs at these two angles, one of those angles is going to be your angle of incidence, and the other angle is going to be your angle of emergence. Understood this? No, Yash, we cannot say that. See, it's not a symmetric curve. Good thinking, but it's not symmetric. But ye yahan tak ye samajh mein aaya? If when I say ki do theta pe delta banta hai, to wo do theta mein se ek theta angle of incidence hoga, ek theta angle of deviation, angle of emergence hoga. Ab if you look very closely, look at, let me keep that triangle over there. If you look at delta m, yes, Ayush, these are always going to occur in pairs. Ek incidence hai, dusra emergence hoga. If theta 1 is incidence, theta 2 will be angle of emergence. If theta 2 is angle of incidence, theta 1 will be angle of emergence. Ab delta m ke case mein socho kya ho raha hai. Delta m, now as I said, delta m occurs at, very nice, Yash. Delta m occurs at an angle of incidence theta m. But let's say mujhe ab समझ में नहीं आ रहा है कि इसमें एंगल ऑफ इमर्जेंस क्या होगा. ओके, सो लेट्स जस्ट से कि माय लाइट इन दिस एग्जांपल गोज फ्रॉम लेफ्ट टू राइट. आई स्टिल डोंट नो व्हाट माय एंगल ऑफ इमर्जेंस इज, बट लेट्स नाउ डू वन थिंग, लेट्स रिवर्स द पाथ ऑफ लाइट. लाइट को वहां से भेजो तो उसका पाथ ऐसा दिखेगा. यू अग्री कि इस सिनारियो में भी डेल्टा एम तो सेम ही होगा. When I send light the opposite way, again same delta hoga, hai na? But now in this case, what should my angle of incidence be? Delta m occurs only at one particular angle of incidence, so it occurs only at theta m. So over here, my angle of incidence should again be theta m. And then all of a sudden, I realize, arey, jab left wala angle theta m hai, and I'm getting minimum deviation. राइट वाला एंगल भी उतना ही है. सो एट मिनिमम डिविएशन लेफ्ट एंगल एंड राइट वाला एंगल आर द सेम. मतलब एट मिनिमम डिविएशन एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस एंड एंगल ऑफ इमर्जेंस बोथ आर सेम. एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस एंड एंगल ऑफ इमर्जेंस बोथ आर सेम. ठीक है, सुमित, जस्ट होल्ड ऑन टू दोज डाउट्स, दे आर नॉट, यू कैन आस्क देम अ लिटिल little later, not strictly relevant to what I'm saying right now. ये समझ में आया? Angle of incidence, angle of emergence same आएगा at minimum deviation, है ना? So at minimum deviation, चलो वापस बता देता हूँ. ठीक है, ये बहुत logical सा argument सुन लो. ठीक है, I'm arguing logically. I'm saying कि I'm considering a case when I have minimum deviation. So what did I do? I sent the incoming ray at an angle of incidence equal to theta m. Sirf theta m pe delta m achieve hota hai. Ab kya ho gaya? This ray, when it finally leaves the prism, it looks like this. I've highlighted it along the blue, with the blue arrows, showing you the path of light. Ab main bas kya karne wala hu? I'm just going to reverse the path of light. So I'm highlighting that with the red arrows. तो लाइट को इस बार मैं राइट से लेफ्ट भेज रहा हूं अलोंग द सेम पाथ. सो सिंस द पाथ इज एग्जैक्टली द सेम, यू आर ऑब्वियसली गोना गेट द सेम एंगल ऑफ डिविएशन इन दिस सिचुएशन एज वेल. बट इन दिस सिचुएशन व्हाट शुड बी दैट एंगल ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड, बिकॉज इफ आई एम अचीविंग डेल्टा एम कैन बी अचीव्ड ओनली एट वन एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस. सो इट कैन ओनली बी अचीव्ड एट थीटा एम. So thus we are proving ki in the scenario when delta m takes place, left hand side wala angle and right hand side wala angle are both exactly the same. Therefore at delta m, angle of incidence and angle of emergence both are theta m. At delta m, angle of incidence and angle of emergence both are going to be theta m. बाकी डेल्टा के लिए आई एक होगा तो ई दूसरा होगा. बट डेल्टा एम में क्या होता है? बोथ एंगल ऑफ इंसिडेंस एंड एंगल ऑफ इमर्जेंस बिकम थीटा एम. गॉट इट टिल दिस स्टेज? Okay. All right. Let's take things further now. All right. So there is. Now, typically when a question is, you'll always see whenever angle of deviation is taught, kya likha hai? However, at delta, one of you is asking something, what is written after at? So it's written, however, at minimum deviation, angle of incidence and angle of emergence are equal. At minimum deviation, angle of incidence and angle of emergence are equal. Okay. Now, let me tell you one thing that you will find written in a lot of textbooks, but I'll just add some more clarity. So you'll find this written in textbooks for minimum deviation. For minimum deviation, naturally, Ketan, naturally. For minimum deviation, rays pass symmetrically through the prism. For minimum deviation, rays pass symmetrically through the prism. Yeah. So normally when a prism is drawn like this, it's found key when the prism is drawn like this, when your prism is, in fact, when these angles look isosceles. Okay. So when a nice prism is drawn like this, you'll find that for delta M, in the scenario when you have delta M, your ray ends up passing perpendicular to the, sorry, ends up passing parallel to the base. Have you seen this or have you been taught this in school? Ki delta M mein, delta M ke scenario mein, your rays end up passing parallel to the base. Okay. Okay. Fine. It's good if you've not learned that because it's not always valid. See, so delta M, you see some textbooks tell you that delta M ke scenario mein, the rays end up passing parallel to the base. Why? Because quite clear hai ki angle of incidence and angle of emergence to barabar hai. To perfect symmetry ke karan ye minimum ye beech wala ray base ke parallel se parallel pass hote hue niklega, you know, because of the perfect symmetry. So this is what textbooks will tell you, but sometimes what textbooks fail to tell you is that the specific prism they are drawing is an isosceles prism. Jaha pe wo dono angle barabar hai. Okay? So only when the two angles are the same, tab ye base ke parallel jata hai. So let me add some insight to that. Do you think agar main yaha pe thoda extra material dalunga, है ना, अगर यहाँ पे मैंने थोड़ा एक्स्ट्रा मटेरियल डाल के बेस को ऐसा कर दिया, विल द पाथ ऑफ दिस लाइट चेंज? इधर नीचे कुछ एक्स्ट्रा एडिशन करने के कारण लाइट का पाथ चेंज हो गया होगा क्या? नहीं. तो अभी भी डेल्टा एम का ही सिनारियो है, बट अभी इज इट लुकिंग पैरेलल टू द बेस? इज द बेस एंड इज दैट पैरेलल? नो. सो इफ यू थिंक अबाउट इट, डेल्टा एम के सिनारियो में द रे इनसाइड need not always be parallel to the base. Okay, for instance, if I draw a diagram like this, okay, so if consider ki my prism is like this, a lot of people think ki delta M ka diagram fir aisa banna chahiye. Okay, they think ki this should be delta M. Problem is, this is wrong. Okay, it need not always be parallel to the base. This ray need not always be parallel to the base. Rather, you will say it will be parallel to what could have been. Rather, you'll say it will be parallel to what could have been the isosceles base of the prism. See, it would be parallel to what could have been the isosceles base of the prism. What do I mean by that? Okay, so let me just say this. Ye diagram mein, same diagram mein, you can draw an isosceles base. Okay? Tumhari marzi se take any one corner and try to make this prism isosceles. So if I try to make this isosceles, I would end up drawing a base like this. Ye extra portion ko nikal do. Try to make it isosceles. So when you try to make it isosceles, this last side will have to look like that. It is going to end up going parallel to that. Okay? So when this light ray enters, if you just want to visualize how does your refracted ray look at the case of delta M, your refracted ray is going to look like this. It's going to end up moving parallel to the isosceles base of the prism. It's going to end up moving parallel to the isosceles base of the prism. Got it? So one of you is asking why parallel kyu aata in the first place. Think about it. I and E barabar hai. I and B E barabar hai. Matlab R1, R2 barabar hai. So you're going to expect every angle in this diagram to be the same. If I and E are the same, R1, R2 are the same, then these two angles also must be the same. Yeah, these two angles must also be the same. I and E to barabar hai. I and E barabar hai, to Snell's law se ye do angle bhi barabar aayega, R1, R2 bhi barabar aayega. So naturally, ab ye do angle bhi barabar aayega. So that's how your ray technically passes. Your ray passes equally inclined to both surfaces of the prism. Samajh mein aaya? Delta M ke case mein, tumhara ray dono surface ke saath barabar angle banayega. Tumhara ray dono surface ke saath barabar angle banayega. It just so happens that if your prism itself is nice and symmetrical, to tumhe wo ray parallel dikhega. Because if it has to make equal angles with both prisms, both surfaces, then it will have to be perfectly parallel to the base in a symmetrical prism. See, that sirf wo symmetrical prism mein waisa dikhta hai. But otherwise, in reality, how does it always move? Delta M mein, these two angles are the same. Delta M ke scenario mein, ye do angle hamesha same hona chahiye. Wo logic samajh mein aaya? Kyun same hona chahiye? I and E barabar hona chahiye. R1, R2 barabar hona chahiye. To ye do angle bhi barabar hona chahiye. Samajh mein aaya? So it always moves parallel to what could have been the isosceles base of the prism. Okay, so here I'm just tackling a misconception. You may end up getting this misconception whenever you write, whenever you read some textbook. Here I'm just tackling the misconception ki rays are not in minimum deviation. The ray through the prism does not always pass parallel to the base. Let me in fact write that. Chalo, ek baar likh lete, a statement likh lete. एक बार स्टेटमेंट लिख लेते हैं, ठीक है? सो फ्रॉम समवेयर स्टूडेंट्स ऑलवेज पिक अप दिस मिसकंसेप्शन बिकॉज दे सी वन डायग्राम, है ना? एंड टेक्सटबुक तो एक केस में डायग्राम बना, एक स्पेसिफिक केस में बना रहा था डायग्राम, बट देन स्टूडेंट्स further extend that and make their own theory. So I'm going to clarify it over here. In the case of minimum deviation, the ray inside the prism will not always be parallel to the base. Itna bol raha hu. Will not always be parallel to the base. See? So in fact, this is not an important point for you to do something with. This is just a point to tell you, don't do something. Don't do something wrong. Don't assume ki hamesha wo base ke parallel hoga. So in the case of minimum deviation, the ray inside the prism will not always be parallel to the base. See? That's not always going to be parallel to the base. This is a common misconception. All right. The rays will be equally inclined. The ray will be equally inclined to the two surfaces where refraction takes place. The ray will be equally inclined to the two surfaces where refraction takes place. Ray will be equally inclined to the two surfaces where refraction takes place. One can also say it will be parallel to what could have been the isosceles base of the prism. All right. So agar ye prism ko isosceles banana padta tha, then we would have had to draw the base like this to make this prism isosceles. So in that case, if you want to draw a line making a base, a new base making the prism isosceles, then you can say, acha wo isosceles prism ke base ke parallel andar reh jayega. Or you can stick to the definition which statement which says ki ye ray is surface or is surface ke saath equal angle banayega. And all of this is just the consequence of angle of incidence being equal to angle of emergence when you have minimum deviation. All right. So the main reason I'm saying all of this is ki तुम इससे ज्यादा कुछ करोगे नहीं, है ना, ये यूज करने का ज्यादा जरूरत नहीं है, बट दिस इज जस्ट एज अ वार्निंग टू नेवर अज्यूम दिस. इवन आई डोंट नो फ्रॉम वेयर स्टूडेंट्स पिक अप दिस मिसकंसेप्शन. आई थिंक सम टेक्स्ट बुक समवेयर जस्ट ड्रॉज अ डायग्राम की ये रे बेस के पैरेलल है, तो स्टूडेंट को लगता है कि मिनिमम डिविएशन में हमेशा बेस के पैरेलल होगा. नो, दैट्स माय होल पॉइंट हियर. मिनिमम डिविएशन में हमेशा बेस के पैरेलल नहीं होगा. मिनिमम डिविएशन में ये दो सरफेस के साथ इक्वल एंगल बनाएगा. इफ यू ड्रॉ अ बेस सच दैट दिस ट्रायंगल लुक्स आइसोसेलीज, तो वो बेस के पैरेलल होगा. गॉट द पॉइंट दैट आई वाज ट्राइंग टू से? दिस पॉइंट इज मोर लाइक अ वार्निंग. जस्ट रिमेंबर कि इट्स नॉट ऑलवेज गोइंग टू लुक पैरेलल टू द बेस. दैट इज द होल आइडिया. यू डोंट हैव टू यूज दिस इन क्वेश्चंस. आई एम जस्ट टेलिंग यू व्हाट नॉट टू डू. तो सारे का इन दैट केस, जिस केस में ये पैरेलली व्हेन यू डू हैव एन आइसोसेलेस प्रिज्म एंड व्हेन यू डू सी दैट द रे इज पैरेलल टू द बेस, दैट रे विल बी इन द कंडीशन ऑफ मिनिमम डिविएशन. ठीक है, तो व्हेनेवर यू सी दिस आइसोसेलेस प्रिज्म एंड यू सी द रे मूविंग पैरेलल टू द बेस, इट विल बी इन द कंडीशन ऑफ मिनिमम डिविएशन विदाउट फेल. ओके, बिकॉज इसका कॉन्सिक्वेंस होता है कि ये दो एंगल बराबर आता है, और ये दो एंगल बराबर आएगा मतलब मिनिमम डिविएशन है. So diagrammatically, this is how minimum deviation looks. Okay, all right. Moving on to formulas. Again, that was just how it looks. So what can be the formula for minimum deviation? Let's try to derive a result. Okay. So there are two formulas for minimum deviation, and you need to remember which formula is always correct. Isme bhi ek hamesha valid formula rahega aur ek approximation hoga. So for all cases, this formula that I'm going to write is going to be valid. So what is the formula? Delta. So let's just derive it. Delta M plus A. Let me start with delta. Delta plus A is I plus E. Ye already humne derive kiya tha. At minimum deviation, I and E are the same. So at minimum deviation, I is equal to E. And R1 is equal to R2. Yeah, guys, I'm back. Can you hear me? Sorry, I'd gone disconnected. You can hear me, right? Just reconnecting my tab. Ab dikh raha hai? Okay, sorry. So angle of incidence is angle of emergence at minimum deviation. And I hope from that you guys can follow that R1 is equal to R2. Make sense? Because in angle of incidence, say R1 nikalta hai, Snell's law ke hisab se. Angle of emergence se R2 nikalta hai, Snell's law ke hisab se. तो इंसिडेंस एंड इमर्जेंस ही बराबर होने वाला है तो आर वन आर टू भी बराबर होगा ओके एंड लेट्स कीप थिंग्स सिंपल आर वन इक्वल टू आर टू को शॉर्ट में लेट्स जस्ट से आर वन अच्छा ए सी आर वन इज इक्वल टू आर टू व्हाट एल्स डू वी ऑल्सो नो ए इज आर वन प्लस आर टू a is r1 plus r2, है ना, so a becomes twice of r1 या twice of r2. तो यहाँ से r1 becomes what? R1 becomes a by 2. So both the angles of refraction become a by 2. So at minimum deviation, all that I've written here is always valid. I is e, and the angles of refraction are a by 2 each. अब बस क्या लगाना है? अब बस Snell's law लगाना है. तो Snell's law क्या बताएगा मुझे? If you look at any surface, ठीक है, consider one surface. This is our ray. Ray enters, and let's say prism का refractive index is mu. Let's say air का refractive index is, let's just say the surrounding medium is air, जिसका refractive index is 1. ठीक है, so what is going to happen? This is my angle of incidence. That is my angle of refraction. So I know ki mu, yeah, let me apply Snell's law. 1 into sin I is mu into sin R1. 1 into sin I is mu into sin R1. This comes from Snell's law. R1, all right? So Snell's law laga raha hu. All of this was just two formulas that we already write. That's applying Snell's law. Sorry, my internet is very shaky today. Voice is also lagging. Let me just try one thing. Ek minute. Let me just try one thing. Abhi fix ho gaya kya? Is it better now? 1 sin I is mu sin R, no voice lag. All right, cool. 1 sin I is mu sin R. Ab iske baad kya aa jayega? To mu ka formula is sin I by sin R. See? U is in R1, substitute everything. So I is before more. So इसको थोड़ा और नीचे ले लेता हूँ. Voice is cracking again. So sorry. Is my voice better now? Better? Okay, chalo. So I'm on my net pack now. Let's hope this works. All right. चलो अब डेल्टा एम मैंने ऑलरेडी लिख लिया है, अभी भी मेरे स्क्रीन में आया नहीं है. दिस इज रियली बैड. एक काम करते हैं, लेट्स जस्ट टेक अ शॉर्ट ब्रेक, ठीक है, लेट्स जस्ट टेक अ 5 मिनट ब्रेक एंड लेट मी जस्ट ट्राई टू फिगर आउट व्हाट टू डू. I already tried rebooting the net. Let me just take a five minute break and I'll just try fixing this in the meanwhile. Yes, guys, please remain in the meeting. And come back by 8:15. All right, I guess it's a little faster now. Yeah. And I hope my voice is clear as well. Let's just hope this lasts. Okay, delta M. Chalo, delta M is kya tha? Delta M plus A is going to become delta M plus A is going to become I plus E. But we can write I plus E as twice of I, you know, because I and E are the same. So I becomes delta M plus A by 2. I becomes delta M plus A by 2. So two things I want you to remember. One is I ka value is delta M plus A by 2. And dusra R ka value is A by 2. Okay, so because of minimum deviation, I ka value is delta M plus A by 2. R ka value is A by 2. Okay. Now when I apply Snell's law, look at what I get. Mu is sin I by sin R. This gives me mu is sine of A plus delta M by 2 divided by sine of A by 2. Sine of A plus delta M by 2 divided by sine of A by 2. This is the original formula, and this formula is always valid. This is the original formula and this is always valid. Always valid. Okay. Always true. This is the original formula. This is always true. And we'll do an example on this formula as well. Okay. But all clear till here? Any doubt till here? This is for minimum deviation. Okay. Ye formula se tum minimum deviation nikal sakte ho. When you plug in the values of mu and when you plug in the value of A, then based on this formula, you can find minimum deviation. They will give you good values so that you can find minimum deviation according to this formula. All right. But that's how this formula works. It's always going to be true. Ab iska ek special case hai. Okay. So iska special mu bhi diya. Of course, see, sawal agar tumhe kuch puchega, they'll always give you enough information needed to solve the question. So delta M agar is formula se nikalna hai, question has to give you A and has to give you mu. Okay? They will give you A, they will give you mu. Delta M depends on mu. And you cannot find delta M without knowing what mu is. So they will give you mu. Alright, now special case formula dekho. Look at what happens to this same result if our prism is very thin. Okay. So, when the prism is very thin, when the prism is very thin, what is going to happen is that if A is small, na, prism is very thin, so naturally A bahut chota ho jayega. Prism would look something like this, patla sa prism. Okay? So A is going to be very small. The angle of the prism is going to be very small. All right. So when the angle of the prism is very small, what else is going to be small? If you think about it, if A is small, then R1, R2 are small. Why? Because A is equal to R1 plus R2. Yeah, na? So R1, R2 is going to be small. If R1, R2 is going to be small, I and E will also be small. Why? Why will I and E also be small? Because I is mu times sin I is mu times sin R. So, jab R chota hoga, I bhi chota hoga. So, basically, when A is going to be small, all of these terms are going to be small. And therefore, delta M will also be small. Delta M will also be small. Okay. So, therefore, what is going to happen to our formula? If you look at that, mu is sin. We are right now stuck with this formula, but can we simplify things a little bit? What is something smart that we can do if all these angles are going to be small? What is a smart thing we can do if all these angles are going to be small? One of you saying sine ko tan kar do. Usse aur easy to nahi hoga. I think tan is still going to be complicated. Shivank, very nice. Yes, sine theta ko theta kar do. When angles are small, sine theta will be the same as theta. So that is the smart thing to do over here. Isko approximately bol do. This can approximately be taken as A plus delta M by 2 divided by A by 2. If you remember, when theta is very small, sine theta is approximately theta. Sine theta is approximately theta when theta is very small. Yeah, na? Approximately tan theta as well. But tan theta doesn't make things nice over here. So, hum kya karenge? We will take it as theta. So, sine hata denge. Ab sine hatane ke karan, yahan pe 2 kat jayega. And you get mu is approximately A plus delta M by 2. Or you can, and then vase, you can also find the answer. So, you can say this is 1 plus delta M by A. You know, 1 plus delta M by A. So, 1 udhar le lo. Mu minus 1 is delta M by A. Mu minus 1 is delta M by A. And therefore, you can also say ki delta M ka ek aur formula mil jayega. This is a more common one. But mind you, this is only for thin prisms. This is only for thin prisms. You get delta M is mu times A minus 1. Delta M is mu times A minus 1. So whenever you want to find angle of minimum deviation, you can just simply get mu times A minus 1. Oh, sorry. I'm so sorry. A times mu minus 1. A times mu minus 1. Naturally, A times mu minus 1. Okay, this result is only for thin prisms. This result is only for thin prisms. Got this, guys? Okay, so just try out a question. Okay, chalo, let's just do a few questions. I'll of course repeat the formula since you haven't had time to memorize it. You know? I'll repeat the formula as well. Find the angle of minimum deviation. This is the first question. I'll just write this question, then I'll show you the previous page again. Find the angle of minimum deviation. Find the angle of minimum deviation for an equilateral prism. Find the angle of minimum deviation for an equilateral prism made up of a material of रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स sounds very familiar, made up of a material of refractive index 1.72. What is the angle of incidence? What is the angle of incidence for this deviation? What is the angle of incidence for this deviation? What is the angle of incidence for this deviation and the corresponding angle of refraction? Okay, find the angle of minimum deviation for an equilateral prism made up of a material of refractive index 1.732. What is the angle of deviation, or what is the angle of incidence for this deviation and the corresponding angle of refraction? Okay, that's the question. Somebody wanted to see this page, jaldi dekh lo and let me know when you're done. Done, all right. So you have all your formulas. I'm just going to write all the formulas. जितना जरूरत है R1 प्लस R2 जो तुम मेमोराइज करोगे, डेल्टा प्लस ए इज आई प्लस ई, म्यू इज साइन ए प्लस डेल्टा एम बाय 2 डिवाइडेड बाय साइन ए बाय 2, एंड लास्ट वन इज डेल्टा एम इज ए टाइम्स म्यू माइनस 1. तुम देखो तुम्हें क्या यूज करना पड़ेगा. ऑलराइट, सी व्हाट यू हैव टू डू. Yes, Sarthak. Sanika thoda, I think, galat ho gaya. Yes, Poorna, very nice. Nishant, sahi hai. आने का सही है. So you can check your, yes, Yash, sahi hai. Check if your answers are 60 degrees delta M, 60 degrees angle of incidence, 30 degrees angle of refraction. 60 incidence, 60 delta M, 30 angle of refraction. आ रहा है 60 60 30, डन। सो जस्ट कॉपी व्हाट ऑफ आई जस्ट कॉपी ऑफ दिस फॉर्मूलाज, आगे भी काम में आएगा। Now, देखो सिंपल, फर्स्ट एंड फॉरमोस्ट इज दिस इज एन इक्विलैटरल प्रिज्म, सो ए इज 60 degrees एंड दिस इज बिग, सो यू कैन नॉट यूज द अप्रोक्सीमेट फॉर्मूला, यू हैव टू यूज द एक्चुअल फॉर्मूला, यू कैन नॉट यूज द अप्रोक्सीमेट फॉर्मूला। सो द एक्चुअल फॉर्मूला इज म्यू विच इज 1.732, विच वी नो इज जस्ट अ फैंसी वे ऑफ राइटिंग रूट थ्री, is actually going to be sine a plus delta m by 2 divided by sine a by 2, right? Now sine a by 2 is actually a 60, so sine a by 2 is sine 30, and sine 30 is half. So you have half over here on the right hand side denominator. So isko left hand side mein le loge to wo numerator mein chala jayega. So root 3 into sine 30 is sine a plus delta m by 2. So root 3 into sine 30 is sine 60 degrees plus delta m divided by 2. Now when you look at root 3 by 2, you immediately realize ki this is actually sine 60. So we know ki sine 60 degrees is sine 30 degrees plus delta m by 2. So what will delta m by 2 have to be? What will delta m by 2 have to be? Delta m by 2 has to be 30. For the two signs to be equal. So if delta m by 2 is 30, yahan se aa jayega ki delta m is actually 60 degrees. So that's how we will get delta m. Okay, that's how you'll get delta m. Any doubt so far? Finding r is also quite easy. In the scenario in which delta m takes place, a is obviously equal to 2r. So because a is equal to 2r, we get that as a result of all of this, r is how I predicted delta m. Achha, somebody wants delta m again. Wapas dekho. Ek pehle to a bada hai. A bada hai, to hum hamesha main formula use karenge. Main kya hai? Mu is sine a plus delta m by 2. Now I substituted the value of a. So a was 60, so a by 2 is 30. Sine 30 is half. साइन 30 को इधर ऊपर लेके गया तो लेफ्ट हैंड साइड हो गया रूट 3 बाई 2 इज साइन 60 प्लस डेल्टा एम बाई 2, ऑलराइट? सो यू थिंक एंड थिंक अबाउट इट, रूट 3 बाई 2 इज ऑफ कोर्स साइन 60, है ना? सो देयरफॉर 60 डिग्रीज प्लस डेल्टा एम बाई 2 विल हैव टू बी इक्वल टू 60. यू कैन ऑल्सो से रूट 3 बाई 2 इज 120, बट देन यू विल गेट अ वैल्यू ऑफ डेल्टा एम विच डज नॉट मेक sense, it will be bigger than 90. So root 3 by 2 kya hai? Simple, sine 60 hai. So 60 degrees has to be on the right hand side, 60 degrees plus delta m by 2. So yahan pe maine bas kya kiya, 60 ko 2 se divide kiya. So 60 degrees 30 degrees plus delta m by 2, so naturally delta m by 2 has to be 30. Actually delta m by 2 has to be 30. Theek hai? अच्छा, फिर और क्या है? a इज इक्वल टू 2r, r इज इक्वल टू a बाई 2, तो r आ जाएगा 30 डिग्री, नो प्रॉब्लम देयर, r आ जाएगा 30 डिग्री. बस अब क्या रह गया? i रह गया. ये साइन इनवर्स दोनों तरफ ले लो. अच्छा, एंड i कैसे निकालोगे? म्यू इज साइन i बाय साइन r. Mu is sine I by sine R. So, yahan se I bhi aa jayega. So, we get root 3 is same story of sine 30. Sine 30 is actually half. तो रूट थ्री इज हाफ साइन आई, तो यहां से तुम्हें फिर से मिलेगा कि साइन आई भी रूट थ्री बाई टू है, तो रूट थ्री बाई टू तो वैसे साइन ऑफ 60 डिग्रीज भी होता है, या रूट थ्री बाई टू, अच्छा वन ऑफ यू इज इनफैक्ट सेविंग माई टाइम, वन ऑफ यू सेइंग कि ये भी करने का जरूरत नहीं है, यहाँ से भी आएगा, स्नेल्स लॉ से भी आएगा, बट वन ऑफ यू सेइंग कि स्नेल्स लॉ तो ऑलरेडी लगा दिया है, तो आई के लिए दूसरा लेट्स यूज दैट अदर इक्वेशन, डेल्टा प्लस ए, डेल्टा प्लस ए इज आई प्लस ई, एंड उससे क्या आया था, आई इज डेल्टा प्लस ए बाई टू, आई इज डेल्टा मिनिमम प्लस ए बाई टू, लेट्स यूज दिस, 60 प्लस 60 बाई टू, तो आई बिकम्स 60, है ना, आई प्लस ई इज डेल्टा प्लस ए, बट आई एंड ई आर द सेम, सो 2i इज डेल्टा प्लस ए, सो आई इज डेल्टा प्लस ए बाई टू, गॉट इट, we'll try some more, yeah a is obviously 60, okay, isi question ko ek thoda sa variation dete hain, can you try the same question if the angle of the prism is, if it's not equilateral but if the angle of the prism is 2 degrees, can you try to find the same thing if the angle of the prism is 2 degrees? स्मॉल एंगल है, जस्ट ट्राई कर लो केयरफुली, म्यू इज 1.732, तो इससे मतलब दो अच्छा एग्जाम्पल देखेंगे ऑफ, है ना, व्हेन टू यूज विच फॉर्मूला, यस आयुष, यस यश, यस सानिका, सही है, यस श्रेया, सिक्सटी इज नॉट करेक्ट फॉर दिस क्वेश्चन, अनुषा सही है, गुड, यू शुड बी गेटिंग, यस शुभम, you should be getting 1.464, Sumit, very nice, yeah, as some other people have written it, 2 root 3 minus 1, ek hi cheez hai, what about the other angles, also find corresponding angles of refraction and angles of incidence, find the corresponding angle of refraction and the angle of incidence. Yes, Tarun, Ayush, Sayyid. Yes, Tarun, Sayyid. Ayush, Sayyid. Sanika, Sayyid. Sumit, sahi hai. I think you'll find that when the prism is small, it's actually a lot easier. And in most cases, prism normally they keep it small only. Okay. Yes, everyone who has messaged me, you've all answered correct. You'll get R as 1, and you'll get I as root 3. यश कैसे यार, पुटिंग इन एक्चुअल फॉर्मूला कैसे आएगा सेम रिजल्ट? तुम एक्चुअल फॉर्मूला में डालोगे तो यू विल बी फेस्ड विद साइन ऑफ 1 डिग्री इन द डिनोमिनेटर. अच्छा कैलकुलेटर, कैलकुलेटर थोड़ी होगा तुम्हारे साथ एग्जाम में. So you're saying according to the calculator, the answer is close. That's fine. See? But what are you expected to do in the exam? In the exam, when you're given such a small angle of incidence. Okay? So I'll just write this over here. Answer the previous question. Answer the previous question. If the angle of the prism is 2 degrees. Okay, so answer the previous question. The angle of the prism is 2 degrees. Okay. First thing is we'll acknowledge ki because A is 2 degrees, there's obviously a small angle. So because this is small, we are allowed to use this simple formula for delta M. This is a direct formula. A times mu minus 1. So things become very simple. Okay, so some of you have written it as 2 root 3 minus 1. That's also fair. And some of you actually use the value of mu that was given. 1.732 minus 1. That's also fair. So this becomes 0.732 minus 1 is 2 into 0.732, approximately 1.4. Exactly 1.464 degrees बनेगा. ठीक है, तो ये आंसर आएगा. एक बार ये आंसर आ गया, R तो है ही तुम्हारे पास. R is a by 2, तो R is definitely 2 degree का आधा हो गया. R is 1 degree. ठीक है, and I क्या हो जाएगा? I is a plus delta m divided by 2. So I is going to be it's going to actually come out to be root 3 again. So it's going to be A, which is 2 plus 1.464, okay, divided by 2. So you'll find ki this is 1 plus 0.732. So naturally, it's again going to be root 3. So I is also root 3 degree. Some have written root 3, that's also fine. Commutative property is not possible since it is in what context are you saying? यहाँ पे कम्यूटेटिव का सवाल कहाँ से आ रहा है? एन एंगल ऑफ करेस्पॉन्डिंग्स, करेस्पॉन्डेंस क्या है? स्मित क्यों पूछ रहा है वो एंगल ऑफ करेस्पॉन्डेंस? आई डिडंट मेंशन इट एनीवेयर ओवर हियर. मैं बोला क्या? आई डिडंट यूज द वर्ड एंगल ऑफ करेस्पॉन्डेंस. सिंपल सी बात है, आई जस्ट सेड कि दिस एंगल इज स्मॉल, दिस एंगल इज स्मॉल, सो वी विल यूज दिस फार्मूला एंड देन आई जस्ट सॉल्व करके आया डेल्टा एम इतना आता है. तुम कुछ लोग ने 2 रूट 3 माइनस 1 लिखा है, कुछ लोग ने 1.464 लिखा है, एक ही बात है. रूट 3 को 1.732 लेके वही आंसर आता है. आर इज ए बाई 2, सो आर इज 1 डिग्री एंड आई इज नेचुरली रूट 3 डिग्रीज. ओके cool. So I'll end things over here. Let me know if you have any doubt in that, but just want you to attempt 2 questions for which we'll discuss in the next class. And of course there'll be homework as well. But the 2 questions I want you to attempt look like this. Bahut simple hai. My light ray is coming like this. for both these prisms, and I have given ki mu is root 2 for both the prisms. The light ray is entering perpendicularly and mu is root 2 for both prisms. Mu is root 2 for both. But yahan pe the angle is 30 degree. And wahan pe niche the angle is 60 degree. Okay. I want you to find delta. Okay. So, maine actually just, if you see the bigger picture, there is not a lot to do in prisms. Prism mein, there is a formula of minimum deviation. And if you look at these two examples, I made it quite clear. Ye jab angle bada diya hai, tum actual formula use karoge. Aur jab angle chota diya hai, to tum ye approximate formula use karoge. But that is one type of question. Seedha minimum deviation ke formula ke upar. Dusra jo type hota hai prism mein, in that they just use prism as a tool. And what it really is it's a question on refraction. Yeah, so these questions, the remaining questions on prisms will just be a question on simple refraction. So to answer these questions, you just need the basic ideas of refraction. All right. So you can try this at home and we will discuss this in the next class. Okay. Which is, I think, on Wednesday. Chalo. Thanks for being patient. Bye. Yes, Sumit. A do example hai. Find delta. This is part 1, part 2. Ek A 30 hai, dusra A 60 hai. Please upload. Ha, recording and notes will be done. Nishant. Nahi. Itne do and HCV ka main khol ke deta hun. I think HCV homework will be till 33. Oh, I'll send a message. HCV homework till exercise 33. No note base. How do you determine A? A has to be given. So I have given that A is this, man. Come on, A is the angle at the top. So that will be given to you. I've given 30 and 60. So the question is, I have given these slabs, I've given these two prisms, right angle prisms, and upar ka angle 30 ek case mein, dusre case mein 60 hai, and I'm asking you to find delta, but be careful, all right? So you just apply the simple concepts of refraction that you already know. And try to find delta. Simple. Light rays entering like this. Aage ka kahani kya hoga? Dekh lo and try to find delta. Okay. And don't treat it lightly. Spend time. Okay? Be careful. So I'll add that last bit. This is perpendicular. This is perpendicular. Okay? If it wasn't evident. This is not a case of minimum deviation. Nay. No, Ame, that's not the answer. Take time. Garpe, over time leke, aram se karo. Refraction ka sawal hai. Okay. Ame to shayad sirf aisa answer kar hai ki ye enter karne ke baad delta kya ho. Delta to pura kahani. Dono refraction ke baad kya delta hai, that's what we want to know, of course. Right, bye. Yeah. Yes. See, you'll want to draw some nice diagrams and carefully solve these questions. These are good questions, both of them. Take time and solve. Take time, but get it right. Bye. Bye. Good night.